although all people are unique, I can distinguish three common filters that most people use. One, lack of trust in relationships. Two, desire to control everything. Three, difficulty in decision making or taking responsibility. And let's talk a little bit in detail about each of these filters. Let's talk about lack of trust in relationships. Lots of people are afraid to commit in relationships. I receive many emails where people are asking how they can trust their partner. One of the most popular videos on YouTube, one of my most popular videos on YouTube, is called Consequences of Dating a Married Man. Trust is something that people want more than anything, but at the same time, it's the hardest thing to create. The cause of this filter, I cannot trust my partner, can be abandonment by one of the parents in childhood. It can be early death of one of a parent. It can be serious illness of a caregiver. It can be a parent's divorce, especially when children are between age 10 and 14. Sometimes there is no actual divorce, but the kids know that one of their parents is cheating on the other one. I talk a lot about how trust issue is developed in my webinar entitled Emotional Eating Oral Type Personality. Although emotional eating and trust issues looks like two different topics, they share the same fundamental base. And you can find this webinar on YouTube, or you can just check the description below this video, and I will include this free webinar in the description. Let's talk about the second major filter that most people use, which is desire to control everything in life. For example, a woman can say that she has to do everything for her husband because he might forget or miss or misunderstood something. Another example of this filter is when a boss cannot really delegate the job to another person and he has to manage and control everything himself. And the third example of this common filter is when parents do not allow kids to make their own mistakes. They might expect a 12-year-old child to act like an adult, or they might expect that a 6-year-old child will not be messy and will be very clean and organized. The third common filter that I see in my practice is the inability to make decisions or take responsibility. Often this happens with people whose parents were going through a complicated divorce. It is also common with people whose parents always argued and were trying to pull the child on one side. One of the hardest things for any child is to pick one parent's side. If I choose mom, I have to reject my dad. If I choose dad, I have to reject my mom. Mother and father represent the whole world for the child. And as a result, the child is becoming indecisive. The child cannot pick between mom and dad. The child cannot reject one of the parents. And even if the child does it, in reality, it's only a mask, it's only a filter. Inside, the child is struggling and feeling a huge pain and huge emotional trauma that he cannot process. He has to suppress those feelings and his pain. So a child is learning that to make a decision can be extremely painful. And the child is learning not to make any decisions at all. It's better not to make any decisions. It's better not to choose anything. And often I see adults who come to me because they are struggling in understanding themselves. They don't even know what they really want. They have extremely hard time of understanding or choosing what they want in life. Example of this filter might be a person who is in a romantic relationship for 5, 7, 10 years and still not sure if his partner is the one. Another example is a person is in his 30s who does not know what career path to choose. A person does not really know what makes him happy. He is so afraid of making a choice that he cannot even be aware of his own desires. It takes time and therapy to rebuild the inner self. It takes time to find the connection within yourself, to understand and to be aware of your own feelings and your own desires. The deeper the trauma, the longer the therapy. But it's possible. A person can be genuinely happy in their 40s, 50s, 60s, and even 70s. And I know a woman who remarried the fifth time when she was 70, and she's extremely happy in her new marriage. So if a person is willing to discover their own potential, then I will be happy to guide them in their journey.